Good morning, YouTube. I'm Jason. This is my garage, and today I'm going to be digging into the clutch master cylinder on my 95 Miata back behind me here. Just picked this up a couple of weeks ago, and I've been going through trying to get it cleaned up and drivable so that my wife can enjoy it for the rest of the summer. And my last video, we got the interior gutted and 10 years of barn crap swept out of it. So it is now looking presentable, even though it still needs a lot of work, a lot of updates, a lot of new parts, but it's presentable, drivable. And now we're moving on to some of the mechanical issues it's got. I've got parts showing up left and right, so that's been good. I'm going to tackle the clutch master cylinder and slave cylinder in this video and try and get a decent clutch feel back in this thing. The master cylinder is leaking pretty severely. Right now, when you hit the clutch, it just goes to the floor. Doesn't disengage the clutch at all. So it makes it tricky to drive this thing. It does start and run and drive. You just gotta, you get one or two pumps out of that clutch, and then there's nothing there. So I'm hoping by the end of this video, I've got that tackled. After that, we've got exhaust work to do. So lots coming up. Stay tuned. So there's the guilty part right there. It might be a little hard to see, but that whole cylinder is wet with brake fluid, clutch fluid, whatever you want to call it. So I'm going to get that ripped out of there. And I got a new one on the workbench that we're going to slap in. And same thing for the slave cylinder. So slave cylinder is the same way. I don't know if you can see that. But it is... it's not as bad as the master, but it is definitely leaking. So I've got a new slave as well. And we're going to get that stuck in there and bleed the whole system. And hopefully we have a nice solid clutch at the end of this. So I'm going to jump in and we'll see what happens. All right. The old master cylinder is out. I mean, it couldn't be easier. There's two bolts holding it on. Right. There's two studs coming out of the firewall right here. Just pull the nuts off of those, and that loosens up the master cylinder here. And then, of course, you've got to loosen the nut holding the clutch line to the master cylinder, and then it just pulls right out. So I've got the new clutch here. I'm going to go ahead and drop that in, get that bolted into place, and we'll fill it with fluid. And then we'll move down underneath and replace the slave. All right, there's the best view of the slave cylinder that I can get you. So we got two bolts to remove here, one on top, one on the bottom, and we got the clutch line itself. It's got to come off, and that's going to come out pretty much the same way as the master cylinder up top. Slap in a new one, and we're on our way. And with only minimal cussing, the slave cylinder is out. And it's loose and floppy and leaking. I think a replacement's going to go a long way towards helping this clutch operate the way it's supposed to. So I'm going to get the new one in there, and then we can put fluid in it, get it bled, and should be all set. Oh, the joys of old cars. So I got the new clutch slave cylinder in, but now I've got the hard line is just kind of floating loose here. You see that moving around? It shouldn't be moving that much. So I got to figuring out what's going on. Let's see, the hard line for the clutch comes over here, mounts this bracket. There's this nice rubber hose that goes down here. And it's the other end of that rubber hose is attached to a bracket that's just vibrating loose, or just swinging free inside the engine bay with the other end of the clutch hard line on it. So somebody's been in here messing before, took it apart, and then didn't put it back together. I'm guessing they were trying to figure out what was going on with the clutch and gave up. So I don't know where that bracket goes, so I've got to figure out where all that stuff attaches and try and get it put back together correctly.
Okay, it is the next morning, and I have finished bleeding the clutch system in the MX-5 here, the Miata. And man, did that make a big difference in the clutch pedal feel. Got a nice clean fluid in the clutch now, and then while I had the brake bleed tool out, I went ahead and flushed the brakes. Got nice clean fluid in the brake system, so we got good pedal feel there. So that does it for the clutch, and I think everything's working the way it should now. All right, so you can see I got it back down on the ground on all four wheels. I just finished up a quick oil and filter change. I didn't record that. I didn't think anybody cares to see a simple oil and filter change. While I was doing, or before I did that, I also adjusted the clutch pedal a little bit, got rid of some slop in the clutch pedal. That's feeling really solid now. So next step, I think I'm gonna go ahead and fire this thing up and make sure it starts, and then I'm gonna take it for a quick lap around the neighborhood and just make sure it shifts through the gears okay. Okay, got a new battery in it. I'm gonna try starting this thing and see how it does. It's loud. That's enough. The only thing I'm waiting on now is exhaust parts and a shifter rebuild kit. Top seal on the shifter is disintegrated, so I'm going to replace that as well at the same time that I do the exhaust. And I think those two things there will mechanically get this sound enough that we can start cruising around town in it and probably then discover the other issues it has. So while I'm waiting on parts, I'm gonna call this video good, and in the next video I'm gonna get into cutting and polishing this black single stage paint. So stick around and watch for that next one. If you haven't hit that subscribe button, I would really appreciate it if you could do that for me and hit that notification bell. That would really help me out. And until the next one, talk to you later.